He said, on this side of the world.
You told me you came up, man.
500 years, man.
Then you said you was in the tribe of Issachar, and I asked you a simple question. What does Issachar mean? You didn't have the answer.
You're
not qualified to go.
I know so much more about the 12 tribes than you know.
Well, I asked you a question. I asked you a question.
I made the most important scientific discovery since Einstein about the 12 tribes.
You know what, Einstein?
Okay, you know about Judah, right? You know about Judah?
I know some things about Judah.
Okay, what does Judah mean? There he goes. That's a great
sign. Yeah, Rob, so one of the things you don't know.
Nah, I've been getting it, yeah.
You got him?
Yeah.
Well,
first Judah is Yahawada.
That's right.
The so-called Jews say Yehudi. Yep. And the word means this. It goes back to, what was that, Leia?
Yep.
It not goes Princess back to Leia.
Not Princess Leia. Although she was a princess.
Yeah.
Leia had a son and said, He was a fourth-born son.
Khan.
Fourth-born son. And when she had, because she had a race with her sister, Rebecca, all right? And she had the son, and when she had the son, you know what she said? She said, thank you, Yahweh. Yahweh, da. Da means thank you. Or da means thanks.
The water.
The full way of saying it, the correct way is, Yahweh Dawad.
Come.
But the short form is Yahweh Da. Yahweh thanks. But thank you, Yahweh.
Uh-huh.
That's what his name is.
You don't even know that, man.
Benjamin. The tribe of Benjamin. You know what Benjamin means? Bun. Bun means son. Bun Yamyan, son of the right. Or right son. Okay? Levi. Lawyer. Hebrew for join unto me.
Taking notes.
Simeon. Shemaiwan, which means he is affliction hurt. Affliction hurt. All right.
Yeah, even he had to shake his head.
Who's Gad?
How about 30 seconds? Can I have 30 seconds?
You had to turn for Gad.
Gave you a chance. You blew
what
it.
What about Gad?
You won't give me a chance.
Who's the tribe of Gad? Where's the tribe of Gad today? And who are they?
There are people born in the beginning of the spring.
Who is the tribe of Gad?
Asher are the people born after them in May.
What does Asher mean?
And Naphtali are the people born in the
desert. What does Naphtali mean? Naphtali, what does Naphtali mean?
Told you, that's that book of Enoch.
You don't know that.
Yeah.
Not Naphtali, my wrestling.
Okay, I got that.
Yeah, my wrestling, all right? Asher. Asha,
can I have my 30 seconds?
No, man, no. You had your chance for 500 years over there.
I told you I had a very important point. You don't even want to hear it.
You Edomites.
Here's my
AKA so-called white people. No,
brother.
No, brother. I can call you brother, by the way. I call you a brother because Esau is a brother to Jacob. You are brothers, but you are wicked, evil brothers, man. You done pushed your mischief on the earth for the past 2,000 years, really.
What I'm about to explain explains
no,
that.
No, you don't got to explain that.
I can explain that.
I got your number, man.
You can't explain that.
We already got your number.
Here's my explanation.
No, we got your number, man. We already got your ticket already.
Here's my explanation. The curse of Jacob upon Simeon
and Levi. We answered that already.
Applies to Moses.
What?
Because it says in the beginning of Exodus chapter 2 that Moses' mother and Moses' father were both of the tribe of Levi.
Watch out. But became the, okay, I'll go.
Moses is cursed.
I got a question for you. Okay, if Levi was cursed.
So if the words of Moses are cursed, then all the rest you're complaining about is bad.
If that's the case, then why would the Most High raise up Levi to be the priest, and the only people that could deal with the priesthood and the Levites were the only people that could deal with the Ark of the Covenant?
The answer is he cheated.
Who cheated?
Moses.
How? The Most High set him up. Why would the Most High set up a Levite to deliver the Israelites at that time?
Yeah, if they were cursed.
If he was cursed, why would the Most High not raise up a Gad?
There were two Levites. Two Levites that he raised up.
Moses
to go before
and Aaron.
Yeah.
He said, go speak. And then the Most High gave Moses his name, man. The first
man. You know that Moses was the king of Israel, right? He was the first king of Israel.
That's right.
So-called declared, yeah. But I'm saying it's bad. It's bad news. So, you're complaining about bad news. I'm giving you an explanation that the ways of Moses were cursed as too cruel and wrongful to take the land from the Palestinians and claim it's for the Jews. That's wrong.
No. You're going somewhere.
What?
You don't understand.
How did Moses do that?
You don't know.
What Moses is he talking about?
What Moses is he talking about?
Talking the one in the book of Enoch.
Thinking you got the Jewish people and the Palestinians fighting over the land of Israel, and the land don't belong to neither one of you.
And then the people that call themselves Palestinians are not even Palestinians.
That's right,
what it is.
The Palestinians are the Philistines, which they were they were Hamites, but
whoever had the land deserved it, and Moses didn't have the right to take it away.
Yes, he did.
Who had the land first? That's easy. The Canaanites.
Who were the Canaanites, Mr. Bible?
The Africans. That's basic.
Okay. You don't know the Bible.
They were Hamites.
The Canaanites. You know what you are.
I am a scientist.
No, you're not.
What does the word science mean? What does the word science mean? Well, you don't know. You are a temple.
You a goldfish. You are a goldfish. That got
not
jumped
even that. Don't even get him into that.
You a temple.
He's an enigma, man.
You are an enigma.
You're like
a tadpole that got dropped off in the ocean, man. Or like a goldfish.
I say the 12 tribes are a lesson in astrology.
No, it's not. So you're an Edomite.
You're part right. Because the so-called astrology links up with the 12 tribes. Because that's in Revelation 22. So you got...
We agree on that.
Woo! One for the white guy.
Now you can leave.
Now you can leave. Let's go to that. Now you gotta go to that.
Resist the devil and he shall flee.
Yeah, he couldn't. He was real.
Got one.
That's how serpents are.
Yeah.
Serpents in the grass.
Yeah.
And he sees an opening. He saw he had an opening, man. What are you doing? Subtown, man.
He tried to bite and got bit back.
He bit himself.
That's Esau. Because Esau, I got you, brother. Hey, this is Psalms 58:3. It said the wicked are estranged from the womb. They go astray as soon as they be born. See, like he came up telling lies. He just came up lying, man. And then he asked us a question, and then we answered this question according to the Bible, and then serpents wiggle. Like when you try to grab a snake, if you've ever had dealings with snakes.
Right, he was wiggling, trying to wiggle his ass out.
You know, like when you grab a snake, they start.
We put him in the bag like Bruce Lee did it under the
jacket. Yeah, he got some
put him in that bag, he put it. The tail started.
Yeah. Oh yeah, he got the snake.
And then he brought it out against him.
Oh, he tapped it on the head first.
He walked
his ass up.
And then remember, he was like,
get up.
He started crushing it out, but he went.
Yeah. And then the snake, when he put it down, he was trying to send the wire to Mr. Breakaway, and he put his foot on the snake's head. Remember that
snake? Right, well, that's Jacob. That's Jacob.
Yeah, yeah, cut.
Yeah, yeah. Because
the snake was trying to slither away. He was going, he was sending the wire to Mr. Breakaway. Yeah, that's what we did to him. You know, we were doing the thing, and he tried to slither him.
Hey, you gotta charm the snake. You gotta charm the snake, right?
They go astray as soon as they be born, speaking lies. Their poison is like the poison of a serpent.
You had your chance in the past. Well, 2,000 years, as Apostle said, but I'm going to say on this side of the world, for the past 600 goddamn years, we've been listening to you, man.
No, he lost back 2,000 years ago.
2,000 years
when,
ago.
When Yahweh Shah was fasting.
That's right.
He threw them three questions. Yahweh Shah cut him with
you, man. That's right, man. We've been listening to you, Esau.
No, he don't got nothing.
We've been listening to you, Edomites, man, for your shit. All this, look, man, you had your chance, man.
That's it.
You had your chance. You had your goddamn chance to be the devil. You had your chance to put your shit out there. So now, your time is over, man.
No mas.
Like Roberto Duran said, no mas. Your time is over, man. It's the time for Yahweh Shai. See, Yahweh Shai ain't get his turn yet. See what I'm saying? So all you niggas out there, you want to be like Nate. I got to bring you up. And General Yohanna.
He's just one of the snakes.
You a snake,
he's
man. You motherfuckers all about glorying yourself. You all about uplifting yourself.
All right, I'm gonna say this. The days of you honoring yourself today shall soon come to an end.
Cut, man. Now, you ain't about Yahweh Shai. That's why you refuse to say
You don't even say the name. You don't even say the name.
General Yahweh. It's the commanding General Yahweh. I'm the
Nobody
guy.
Whoever takes him serious, he's got the elevator don't go to the top.
All you guys are out of there. Oh, and Comfy. We don't even talk about you.
No, he's not easy.
He's not even relevant anymore.
Yeah.
Comfy, what?
Who? How the hell are you guys going to talk about you? Yahweh Shai hasn't got his glory yet, man.
Yeah.
Yahweh Shai get his first, man. He gonna get it too.
And the thing is, them niggas can't save themselves.
Yeah.
You got Nate acting as if he can save himself.
Yeah.
He can't save himself. Gehenna, he can't save himself.
Yahweh Shai gonna clamp.
He can't save himself, and he can't save nobody.
Cut.
Yahweh Shai is the savior.
Yeah, man,
he's the one coming back to save his elect, man.
You watch what Yahweh Shai gonna do. That's why now I understand the scriptures more and more. That's why the scripture says when Yahweh Shai come back, when the Most High finally taps him on the shoulder, so to speak, and say, okay. It's time to get down. That's why the Bible said he's going to descend with a shout, man. A war cry.
Oh, that's, what is that? John 7 and 18?
Yeah.
He that speaketh of himself, John 7 and 18.
Yeah.
That's a good scripture, because you got examples of that.
Cut.
Guys that are trying to glorify themselves.
Yeah, man.
Like Nate and Gehenna.
Cut.
And the scriptures warn us about that. Guys that will rise up and try to glorify themselves. John 7 and 18.
Them guys. And then you got these new upstart chiefs, I'm the chief priest, Alize.
Oh yeah, those guys. Yeah, go ahead, bro.
This is John chapter 7, verse 18. He that speak of himself seek of his own glory.
There you go. You got examples of that. Like Nate, it's really the gospel according to Nate. It ain't the gospel according to the scriptures. It's the gospel according to Nate. That's why he says you don't have to know the name. The name ain't important. The names ain't important because it's according to his gospel.
That's not biblical.
You got to wear, these guys believe, they tell you you got to wear your fringes 24/7. That's what they teach. You got to wear your fringes. If you go on your job, you got to wear your fringes, man.
Okay, but let's say wear the fringes. But the fringes, what is the fringes for? Yeah. Remind you to keep the Lord.
Yeah.
They're not keeping the Lord.
You ain't keeping the Lord because you're all lined up.
They're lined up.
All of you.
They're going off, man.
They're calling on another name.
They're not keeping the Sabbath because they don't know when the Sabbath falls in on.
Right.
The new moon is all messed up.
So it's
they're liars.
Yep.
They're lying. They lie on us.
Oh, don't.
Make some devils.
Don't
the word. The word devil. Well, deceiver, right? But it also the word diablos means slanderer.
Slanderer, right?
Accuser, false accuser.
Well, don't one of the Ten Commandments say, "Take not the name of the Lord in vain"?
Yep.
Absolutely.
That's a law. You did that, Dave.
It also says not to lie.
Well, yeah. one of the commandments in Exodus, it says, you shall not make mention of the name of other gods.
That's right.
Now, when they're talking about Christ, that's another God.
That's another God.
Because the Son of the Heavenly Father, his name is not Christ.
That's right.
All right? And if they want to be technical, when Yahweh Shai walked the earth, it would be Christos.
That's right.
It wouldn't be Christ. It would be Christos, because it was in Greek.
That's
so it would be Iesus Christos, not Jesus Christ. That came way later.
That's right, man.
All right? So, yeah. So they're not even accurate on that. Go ahead.
Back in John chapter 7, verse 18. He that speaketh of himself seeketh his own glory, but he that seeketh his glory that sent him, the same is true.
The glory of him that sent him, Yahweh Baal Shai.
That's right.
He was sent by the Most High. Ultimately, everybody was sent by the Most High. Even Yahweh Shai was sent by the Most High. But then we were sent for apostles. Which, like, hey man, like you brothers call us the apostles, but you brothers that's in the word, technically, you are apostles too.
Yeah, because the word means sent away.
Sent forth.
Sent away.
To do, sent away to do the what?
Do the word.
To Matthew's the 10th chapter.
Gone.
When Yahweh Shai said, these 12, Yahweh Shai sent forth, that's why they were the apostles, and commanded them, saying, go not to the way of the Gentiles, and into any city of the Samaritans. Into ye not, or the Samaritans, or who? Ethiopians, Hamites that were saying that they were Israelites, trying to keep the law, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel, right? And as ye go, preaching the kingdom of heaven is at hand, meaning that the knowledge, the kingdom of heaven starts off with the knowledge, man. So really, the kingdom is already here, man. But now we just waiting for the physical manifestation of it.
Yeah, the kingdom is the word.
Yeah.
The kingdom is the word.
And we're a part
of it. You got brothers talking about when I get to the kingdom. You in the word. You're already in the kingdom.
The kingdom is here. We just wait. Basically,
we just represent a brick.
Well, you said this again years ago. We just pretty much waiting for the part where we just going to get Esau ass and the other nations and kick their ass and sit on thrones, man. We're just waiting for that physical part of it to happen. Which really, it's already happened already. It's already happened. But we still just got to play it out. We got to play out the rest. What's the rest? What we doing right now up until the point where Yahweh Shah actually come back.
And the kingdom
man.
Of heaven is the house of David.
That's right.
The tabernacle of David. But David will sit back on the throne.
That's right.
That's right.
Under Yahweh Shah. See, them other guys ain't even teaching that.
That's right.
You know?
You niggas that don't want to accept David, then the Most High going to destroy you too.
Well, if Nate taught, if I'm wrong, he can correct me, all right? But if I remember correctly, Nate taught that David, the scripture of David, Hosea, the third chapter, that is talking about Yahweh Shah.
Yeah, he said.
Now if I'm saying that misquoted, then you go ahead and correct me. I said, okay, I stand corrected. But I remember when you said it, man. So the Most High is taking that truth away from you, man.
Yeah.
You to go around and tell your congregation that his name is Christ instead of Yahweh Shah, but then you're gonna call them zombies in your camp, they have a coon name.
Coon names, yeah.
But then the name that you got, Daniel, Ben, Yisrael, that's not even the real Hebrew.
Yeah.
But then again, you don't know what the real Hebrew is. I mean, you all fucked up, man.
He's all.
Yeah, but at one
at God first they have the ancient man. Hebrew names.
Right.
Then they kind of switch it up.
Yeah.
Right.
You know?
And he got a couple of guys that have ancient Hebrew names.
Exactly. But he changed them up too.
Yeah, he got one guy named Yahwasap. When they put the videos, the subtitle, it say Yahwasap. Yeah. And then the other guy.
You say correcting the Lord is not the author of confusion.
Right.
So all he brings is confusion.
Confusion,
man.
Right.
But then, where have we brought confusion?
You a demon. You a real goddamn demon, man. And that's why we'll go. And then when I go back to when I saw you, that was 4 years ago. You saluted me with the ancient Hebrew. And then that motherfucker, the whole ass nigga that you are, you told me, look, brother, I know the name of the Most High. I'm telling y'all verbatim. The brother that I put in the car was with me. I know the name of the Most High is Yahweh, and I know his name, son's name is Yahweh Shah, and I teach my congregation that. You told me that.
But then you also teach him to, when you go on camera, don't teach him that.
Yeah.
You a hypocrite, man.
Double-minded man. Unstable and all.
Bring it up.
That's confusion. And at one time.
Well, you know what, man? Let's move it up over there. Come.
At one time, you used to bring the 12 tribes sign out, but you didn't put the so-called names, you know, today. You just put Judah, Benjamin, Levi, and all that. You didn't put the so-called Negro, so-called West Indians, so-called Puerto Rican, you know? And then Apostle Tahar started getting on you. And you put it back, you know? That shows you, Nate, every time you get checked on something, you know, you make it right again, you know? Because the Lord is the one that's correcting you. Through the spirit of the men that you see, you know? So at one time, you had the 12 tribe sign, but you didn't even have so-called Negro.
We didn't even have the 12 tribe sign out. And we used to get on them back in 07, 08. And we got on them so much that he went out there.
Yeah.
And he put it out.
And all these guys do
the part where he was real lined up.
Yep.
And we used to get on him about that. Then all of a sudden, now he got that big congregation. He got a full bid.
Yep.
Yeah.
If you go back maybe 3 or 4 years, he was real trimmed up. He got the congregation.
Yeah.
You know?
That money's tumbling in.
Yeah. So he don't have to be
his
all
attitude,
trimmed up.
If you don't like it, you can leave. Because he got a big congregation.
You got that, and he got the
and
big money
them,
flow.
And we call them zombies, man. Now, if you look up the word zombie,
that's
he's
right.
talking about them. A zombie is a dead person that's been reanimated by its zombie master. And
that's
all
right.
They listen to is the master, zombie master, which is Baron Samedi.
Baron Samedi,
that's another name that we didn't make.
Baron Samedi.
Yeah, that's
the top hat.
Right.
Yeah.
From New Orleans and shit.
Yep.
With the skeleton face.
Yeah.
Baron Samedi.
Yeah.
And from Rapture.
Rapture, yeah.
Blondie.
Oh, Live and Let Die.
The guy that Jeffrey Holder.
Jeffrey Holder played it.
Yeah. Well, I met him, man. And that guy's like that in real life.
Yeah, I'll suck it up.
Yeah, that's Nate, man.
You young brothers wouldn't know who that is, man.
Punch him up.
Yeah, well, that's why they got Google.
Yeah.
They can Google it. Go ahead, bro.
This is James chapter 1, verse 8. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways.
There you go. So that's
Nate,
man.
Yeah, because he did a thing years ago, the true name of the Most High. Then he said the true name of the Most High. He put the word Yahweh. Then he put the Tetragrammaton. Then he put Jehovah. He said Jehovah is not the true name.
They put Yahweh.
So he gave you the truth, but he mingled it with other names.
Yeah.
And then he said, the true name of the Messiah. He put Yahweh Shai. Then he put Yeshua.
Right.
Yep. Then I think he put Jesus.
He put Jesus.
That's not the true name. But it's either Yahweh Shai or Yeshua.
Right.
And then some of his men, they'll be reading. At one time, they will come out and say Yahweh Shai, but sometimes they will say Yeshua.
Right.
So that's confusion.
Confusion. You know? Yeah. And then what is that? Zechariah 14:9. It says, "The Lord's name shall be one," meaning one name for the Heavenly Father, one name for His Son. So why does this guy have all kind of different names?
Yeah.
Because he's a double-minded man, and he's bringing confusion.
Hey, what is his name and what is his son's name?
And those people that he's under are zombies, man. Because no one defies him. No one challenges him.
Con.
Yeah. Including Kanak.
Yeah.
Oh, that dude.
This is James chapter 4, verse 8. Draw near to the Most High, and He will draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, ye sinners, and purify your hearts, ye double-minded.
That's a good scripture.
Yeah.
Give me the one in Leviticus 23:13, is it?
Exodus 23:13. I'm gonna pay for that too, misleading Israel. You scattering the flock of the Lord, which are Israelites.
Oh, that's in Micah, right?
Yeah.
You flay the skin off of them, and oh, ye heads of Israel.
This is Micah. And the reason why those people, the masses, followed Nate is because his whole setup is hooked up, man.
Yeah.
He got some Hollywood production
videos.
He got the garments. They doing the cadence and all that.
Yeah, the marches.
And then people are attracted to that. All right.
Yeah, he pushes the family.
Right, he gives them smooth things.
Yeah.
You know?
You
prophesies unto them deceit. You know?
Yeah, you can come in the truth with your wife and your family.
Teachers have an itching ears.
Now the Lord said a man's foe shall be day of his own household. That's in the scriptures, that's in the prophecy. Because even Yahweh Shai's family, there was only two guys. He had four biological brothers. Two that wasn't even in the ministry of him. Two that was. So that destroys that family concept right there. Because even Yahweh Shai's family, you had members
Peter had to leave his family, even though Peter was in contact with his wife.
Cut,
he didn't say
right.
He had children, but he had to leave them. And Peter was the one that even said that we left all and followed the
right.
Father's
yeah.
deep.
Yeah.
That's right.
And I'm pretty sure his wife got pissed off a couple of times.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So that destroys that family coming in the truth
you
with your family concept. That destroys it, man.
That's right.
What's that?
That's right. Yeah, because he went back there. He left.
That was in the truth, James and
they were doing the word James for three hardcore years for Yahweh Shai. Yahweh Shai.
Paul, Peter was still in contact with his wife.
Yeah, he was. He was still with his wife
because she got, it was her or her mother that got sick.
Her mother
got sick.
Yahweh Shai healed.
That's right. So he was still there, meaning that
he wasn't spending too much time with his wife.
He wasn't spending too much time with her. He was doing the work. But I mean, you brothers that got women, you deal with your woman, but the work come first. And then when you deal with your woman, you deal with her.
Well, that's why Paul said what he said.
Yeah.
In 1 Corinthians 7 chapter. Now, these clowns in the IUIC said they use that scripture to justify that you can only have one wife.
Yeah.
Because, matter of fact, go ahead and read it. You can have more than one wife, but guess what? If you're in this work, That's what Paul was talking about. If you in this work, not only if you're going to have a wife, have one wife, but if you can, be like him and have no woman.
Yeah.
So you can be totally devoted to the work.
Without distraction.
You hardly have time for the woman you got. Right now, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, because you know how women are. Once you give them an inch, they want 6 miles.
That's right. That's right, man. See, that's the thing. What Apostle Paul said, nature pushes the fem. Well, you can bring your woman in the truth. No, man. And that's another thing. I'm always go back to what Spirit had Apostle the hard time me back in the 90s. Because when you first come in the truth, you thinking that vibration. You're going to teach your woman the truth, give her a Hebrew name. Y'all going to go to the school together. No, man. I mean, you do that simple shit and they bite you in the ass. Then you learn, man. You're like, hey, man, when you deal with your women, brother, don't tell them about this thing, man. Just deal with them, man. The truth is, they separate things inside, man. When you deal with the truth, you deal with the truth. Don't try to teach your woman the truth. Make her into an Israelite woman in the truth. Don't do all that. It's a waste of time.
Now, if she wants to learn, you can teach her.
Good.
You can show her a few things, but you got to have her in your mind. She's not going to get this, man.
Good.
She's not, because the emotion is going to kick in.
Good.
You know, women do things based upon emotion.
Good. That's right.
Go ahead.
This is 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1. Now, concerning the things whereof ye wrote unto me, it is good for a man not to teach a woman.
Not to touch
a woman. Nevertheless, to avoid fornication, let every man have his own wife, and let every woman have her own husband.
Now they said, well, that's talking about you can only have one wife. It's not talking about that. The Apostle Paul was talking to the ones that were in the work. He wasn't talking to all Israel. He was talking to the ones that woke up to this truth, that if you're going to be in this truth, it's best not to be like himself. Don't have a woman at all. But if you can't contain it, have one wife. That's what he said.
That's right, that's
and
right.
And then it says in this present distress, meaning in this time we got to do that. Now when the kingdom comes, you're going to have many wives.
That's right.
Now if you got a guy that have two or three wives, you got to watch that guy to see if he, I guarantee you, if he has two or three wives, four wives, I guarantee you he's going to make a million and one excuses. That's why he couldn't make it.
He's not going to be diligent. He's not going to be diligent.
Every 3 weeks, he got to go out of town.
That's right.
You know?
We knew guys like that.
And you can't deal with people like that, man.
Yeah, he won't be diligent.
Rolled up with the last, the end of the next
year. Well, I saw he was full of shit, man. I knew his destiny. I knew his destiny was going to fall out.
And it cost you, man. Yeah, that's right.
says, let the husband render unto the wife due benevolence, and likewise also.
Please, you gotta get the beat. What does that mean? Back in the one west, the guys were going off. That means you gotta worship your woman and put her on a pedestal and kiss her ass. You gotta pop her. You gotta pop her. That's what that's talking about, man.
Wait a minute. Give me Proverbs 5:19.
That means have sex with her.
That's in the law.
You got a woman, you gotta have sex with that woman. You can't deprive your woman of sex.
That's right. When you look up the word ravish, it means rape.
You
get killed saying shit like that.
They go to
Hagen. You've been in America too long, faggot.
Yeah, yeah.
They go to Hagen. There you go.
And those guys that get all messed up by it. And you know what? Nate should be ashamed of himself because he was a scripture man. We used to sit down and reason, go into the Hebrew, remember?
Yeah.
Nate was a scripture guy.
Yeah, yes, he was.
And Bunyan called himself being a scripture guy, But them guys got emotion, man.
Yeah.
Emotion.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Lord took
them. You can't let emotions come into this, man.
That's right.
When you into this book, you can't let emotions.
That's right.
You got to put emotions
to the side.
That's why this is not for a woman. A woman does things based upon emotion. I'll give you a perfect example. You with a woman, she's happy to be with you. You know, y'all might be having sex every other day or whatever. Then you kind of get tired of it. It might be once a week or once every 2 weeks. You know what she gonna do? She ain't gonna tell you. She gonna go find another nigga to get with her old ex-man.
That's right.
Why? And then to her, she's justified in doing that because you ain't treating her right.
That's right.
You ain't taking her out like every Friday like you used to. But they ain't gonna tell you. Because women don't deal with loyalty. They deal with emotion. They do things based upon emotion. Yeah. Watch how many women take that chip, because they're going to get emotional. They said, look, if you don't take that chip, if you got no welfare, no food stamp, you can't work at that cushy job no more. Them women that are working, I'm going to give you another example. I'm going to the DMV, and this older black woman, I had got a ticket because I forgot to re-register my car. But what they, I told her, I said, well, wait a minute, y'all used to send me the registration. She said, that's a courtesy. And she had like a bad negative attitude. I said, you're not going to fuck my name, right? And he said, you should have did it. You should have known what to do. But sometimes you make, you ain't supposed to make no mistakes. And then somehow the Bible came up. I said, you read the Bible? She said, I read it every day. So I said, well, you nothing. You must know about the mark of the beast. And she kind of looked at me. I said, you know what the mark of the beast is, right? I said, the mark of the beast is when you get that microchip. Now, are you going to take that microchip? She said, if I'm forced to. I said, well, you know what the Most High is going to do with you if you take it. Look, I already know what the Most High got for me. So in my mind, I said, you know what, this stupid bitch don't know the Bible. But she says she read the Bible every day. Test it yourself. Go to any woman that claims she read the Bible and question her on the Bible. She might get one answer out of 10.
That's being women, nice.
They're emotional, man. You know how they get close to the Bible's close to their heart? Because it's under their fucking heart. That's how they're close to their heart. They don't read the Bible when they can't read. They can't read. As I said, when they make that just mandatory, you got a lot of people in the world. And they got Christian jobs and benefits. They got to give up all the benefits. You think they're going to do that? They got children. You think they're going to do that for their children? Because all that shit's going to be cut. They don't have it. Look, the scripture says that the serpent deceived them and they received, didn't force them. All they're going to do is say, well, look, the new system is if you want to have Medicaid, you want to have food stamps, you want to have keep your Section 8, if you want to keep this particular job, and especially if you work in a municipal type job. Let's say you work for the train, the subway system,
the MTA.
You know what I'm saying? Let's say you're a toll clerk. Let's say you work in an office. Let's say you work for the EPA. Because that's how it's going to hit. They're going to totally switch that system around. And in order for you to be in the system, you have to have a chip. So what's she gonna do? To get in the building and all that, right? So she's gonna go with it because she's gonna not know to say no. But now once you show it to her, guess what? The motion won't kick in. That ain't talking about it. See, the boss told us, they read that script. Then they gonna make us look bad. Them wicked ass Israelites are saying the mark that chip is the mark of the beast. Don't believe it. Because women do things based upon emotion.
This is Isaiah chapter 32, verse 12. They shall lament for the teats, for the pleasant fields, for the fruitful vine.
Keep reading.
It reads on, upon the land of my people shall come up thorns and briars.
That's the curses. Go ahead.
Upon all the houses of joy in the joyous city, because the palaces shall be forsaken. The multitude of the city shall be left.
That's the curse that we under. Go ahead. That's why we're not in our own homeland. Go ahead.
The forts and towers shall be for dens forever.
Go ahead.
A joy of wild asses.
Go ahead.
A pasture of flocks until the Spirit be poured upon us from on high.
The us is Israel. Go ahead. Right.
And the wilderness be a fruitful field.
And that's when this place is done away with by the missiles. And everything will be a new heaven, a new earth. The new heaven is our kingdom. Go ahead.
And the fruitful field be counted for a forest.
Go ahead.
Then judgment shall dwell in the wilderness, and righteousness remain in the fruitful field.
Go ahead.
And the work of righteousness shall be peace.
Go ahead.
And the effect of righteousness, quietness, and assurance forever.
What verse are you in?
17.
Go ahead.
and my people shall dwell in a peaceable habitation, in sure dwellings in a quiet resting places.
Go ahead, and that ultimately that's what we're gonna get. Go ahead.
When it shall hail coming down on the forest, and the city shall be low in a low place.
Go ahead.
Blessed are ye that sow beside all waters, that send forth thither the feet of the ox and the ass.
Go ahead.
No, that was it.
That was it? I'm sorry. Go to the
8th
verse.
8th verse? 18. The 8th verse says, but the liberal...
What?
The 9th verse?
What the women?
That's right, man.
Hold up, bro.
This thing gonna go down.
Go ahead, speak.
This thing gonna go down, man. That
June 30,
30. Well, the scripture, Job 30, we always put out Job 39, 17. Because it's not given out to them. The women. These women, this truth ain't really woke it. Somebody else grabbed Job
39. You was reading out of Deuteronomy?
Because this truth ain't for the woman, that's what the apostle told her and the rest of us are talking about. When that ship comes, the women are going to take it. But you know what? Through the Spirit of the Lord, we always said this. There are going to be certain women that's going to be delivered out of here.
Can we get that real quick?
Yeah, really. So there are going to be some women that's not going to take, Israelite women, that's not going to take the ship. Why? Because the Most High is going to put a spirit on them. Not to do it. But the majority are going to do it, man. Okay?
Yeah. This is Job chapter 39, verse 17. Because the Most High hath deprived her of wisdom, neither hath he imparted to her understanding.
So they're not going to have the understanding not to take the ship like the apostle said, because they're not going to be told, most of them. But the ones of them that's going to know, because everybody's going to have to deal with the word. We're going to tell them, look, you're going to take that ship. Like brothers, they got women, you're going to tell your woman, or you might tell your mother or your sister that they're going to take that ship. And if they take it, that's their ass. They're going to take it. Yeah.
Oh, that's why the Bible say a man's foe shall be there of his own household. Because
right. You
might be in the truth, and you know, when the time comes for the chip to be passed, you might have your own family member saying, look, I'm going to take that chip.
Yep.
So you're going to be at a difference with your family member. That's what the Lord meant by a man's foe shall be they of his own household. Because not everybody in the family is going to agree, no, we're not going to take that chip.
Yeah.
You're going to have certain members of your family that's going to say, look, we're going to take that chip.
God.
We want to eat.
God.
Now you being full of faith, being in the truth, you're going to say, no, I'm not going to take that chip. Guess what you got in the family? Division. A man's foe shall be they of his own household.
That's what
it is. Because a lot of brothers are going to bug out and their wives are going to take the chip and try to get their kids to do it. And a lot of them guys are going to wind up taking the chip with their wives, man.
Yeah.
A lot of these, some of these guys that see the faith, they're going to push that Bible to the side. Man.
Right. And that's in the Apocrypha, where it speaks about women. It says many have run out of their wits for women. So they're going to listen to their wife like Job. All right, now remember Job, he didn't listen to his wife. Remember his wife, in the book of Job, his wife told Job, curse the Most High and die.
Yep.
But he instead of listening to her, he cursed out his wife. He said, you speak as one of those foolish women speak.
The hell with that shit, I don't give a fuck.
So Job retained his integrity.
God,
you're going to have a lot of guys that's not going to retain their integrity.
Yeah, the scriptures in Revelation, the third chapter, 12th verse, it speaks about the hour of temptation. I think it's called the 10th verse, the hour of temptation.
Come.
Well, the hour of temptation is when they present that chip to you. Then we're going to see among you brothers that call yourself Israelites and believe, we're going to see what you're going to do in that hour.
Right.
You're going to have to make a decision.
Right.
And I'm going to tell you, man, a lot of these brothers, They're going to wind up taking the chip.
Yeah. They're going to
cast the Bible behind
them.
You got that in
Deuteronomy
chapter 32,
verse 15. But Jeshurun waxed fat and kicked. Thou art waxing fat, thou art grown thick.
Now Jeshurun means, and I read this last week, but I didn't go fully into it. Jeshurun, it's Hebrew, the word is Yahshua, which basically means the first. We were the last nation that was established by the Most High. Pursuant to Deuteronomy 7 chapter, we were the last nation, but we were always the first nation. So we're the Most High first. Go ahead.
It says, thou art covered with fatness.
Fatness means riches, because there was one time when we were on top of all the nations. During the time of King David, because during the occasion of the rulership of King David, Edomites were slaves of 100%. And during the time of Solomon. Solomon was in like 40 years of the time of King of Heaven. Alright? Go ahead.
The retort. Then he forsook the Most High. Which
then he forsook the Most High. When did Israel forsake the Most High? When they got all of that riches and they were living good.
Yep.
All these celebrities that made it. Let's go to Floyd Mayweather.
Yep.
When they asked Floyd Mayweather, Black Lives Matter, what did he say? No, all lives matter. Why? Because he's up in that system. He can't knock the system. And when Donald Trump called certain niggas, small niggas, to come see him, they ran and went to see him, man. Yeah, Kanye West went to see him. Steve Harvey. Now Steve Harvey's all messed up. But everybody called him a cool. Because you know he had no business going to see Donald Trump, man. Ain't no nigga got no business seeing Donald Trump.
Yeah, but he went.
What's that chick that was married to John Coffey? You know that motherfucker that died. That big muscle bound nigga.
Oh, John Clark Duncan. Michael Clark Duncan.
Michael, remember him?
Yeah.
That was a major Uncle Tom.
Yeah.
And he married to Amorosa. Remember Amorosa? You don't know Amorosa?
She was on The Apprentice.
She was the first one. Oh. Anytime they saw Trump walking, she was right behind him like a puppy dog. She's like right with this guy, man. So she done sold. Everybody knows she's a cool
lady. Yeah, anyway. She won it one year, right?
I think she was a runner-up, but she had an attitude. She had a bad attitude. That's what made her famous, man.
Yeah.
Then Kanye West went over there. Then certain other Jakes went over there, man.
Yeah, they were like zombies.
They were like zombies. Now Steve Harvey, he's all messed up, but Jake is calling him a cool.
Yeah, he
which he is
done.
A cool, man.
Sure,
you can't explain away. You a goddamn fool, all right? So he made his money, so he turned his back on who he is. This guy, Ali's daughter.
They asked her,
does Black Lives Matter? She said, all life matters. Why? Because she's up in that thing. Serena Williams married a goddamn cracker. And there's a picture of Serena Williams, there she go right here, and she got the leg up. She hugging the crack and got the leg. When you got the leg up, how many of you brothers had a woman where she grabbed you and stuck her leg up? That means she's head over heels in love with you, man.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. You watch all the pictures of Jake man with a Jake woman, you know, she might be like that, smirk on her face, but she's with the crack.
She done saw sweet Jesus.
That's right. So that's what that means, man. Anybody that made like Nate. Nate is doing good. He's a celebrity Hebrew, man. And this dude is a multi-millionaire. He got lawyers backing him up and all that,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, he got it all.
That's all they are, celebrity Hebrews, man. So there's certain things that they gotta do. They can't teach your name, they can't do this, they can't do that. Go ahead.
Then he forsook the Most High, which made him, and lightly.
Then he forsook the Most High, which made him. Now this guy, Mike Epps, he did that. He made mockery of us years back in 2011, and his boy, his partner, Ricky Harris, dropped dead. And he ran into the brother in
Chicago.
He went to Chicago.
Yeah.
He ran into a brother. From GMS, and you know what? He always runs into guys from GMS.
Yep.
Three times. Didn't he come to New York? They don't say he came to New York.
Probably.
He went to a couple of places, and he keeps running into a brother from GMS.
Yeah, that's the Lord, man.
And they keep cutting him.
Yeah.
All right?
Hey, the Lord keep warning him.
The Lord keep warning him, man. But now it's going to be hard for him to apologize and say he's an Israelite, because all that money going to dry up.
Yep.
If he says I'm an Israelite and I'm down with GMS, you think he gonna get the next movie? You know, with Kevin Hart, hell no, man.
Oh.
If Kevin Hart said I'm an Israelite, then my whole quote on 34th Street with the brother from GMS. You think he gonna get any more fucking movies?
Nope.
Hell no.
He could do it anyway. He's sold out.
Yeah, he sold out.
They sold out. They'll kill his ass.
Never come back, man.
They'll kill his ass.
Read that again,
This is Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 15. But Jeshurun waxed fat and kicked.
Jeshurun is another name for Israel. If you're not into this book studying, you ask a nigga woman. She, oh, I read the Bible every day. What does Jeshurun mean? What you mean by that? She don't know what Jeshurun is. That stupid bitch is DMV, man. If I said, well, okay, you read the Bible every day, what does Jeshurun mean? She won't know.
Oh, Proverbs 9 and 13. A foolish woman is clamorous. She is simple and
knoweth
nothing.
And knoweth nothing. All right? Go ahead.
It reads on, thou art waxing fat. Thou art grown thick.
Thou art waxing fat means you rich. You got everything that the heart can desire, man. Go back to Floyd. Floyd always showing off his whip, his car, right?
Right.
And he got a car that's almost $5 million. Go ahead.
It reads on. That
one purchased a fucking one that cost $1 million. Now, if I ever run into him and talk to him, I'm going to say, let me ask you something, Floyd. I said, let me ask you something. What did you realize when you bought that $1 million watch? How many days did it take you for you to realize it's just a fucking watch? But there was one day where he got it. About 3 days, 4 days, he said, this is a fucking watch. You know? My $2 watch can tell time just like your $1 million watch.
Yeah.
And you know what that's called? That's called
decadence.
Conspicuous consumption.
Conspicuous.
You know what that means? Conspicuous consumption means, conspicuous means with, see, you see something that you like and you buy it. In our vernacular, it's called nigger rich. Y'all know what nigger rich is, right?
Yeah.
A nigga hit the lotto, he going right to the dealership with the whole $1 million.